Everyone, this is Ross, and in today's video, we're going to talk about pinching and why this is so important for our fig trees, why I do this every single year, and why you should be doing this too. So right now, you're looking at two dots that are really important to find and locate along the main branch. And why these are so important and how to find them is just pretty simple. You just go along the leaf stem here, and right above the leaf stem that connects to the main branch is those two dots. And that's what you're looking for. Before you decide to pinch, if those two dots are not present, pinching is not going to work. One of those two dots is going to be a fig, and one of them is going to be a new branch. So when we take off the tip here and we break this off with our thumb, it's called pinching for a reason, right? We're literally just pinching this branch off. It's that easy. You don't have to come in here with pruning shears. It's a very common question I get. You can. If you can, also preserve as many leaves as you can. That's also going to be very beneficial, obviously, to the tree. But just take off the tip, and you can break this off. And what that's going to do is change up the hormones in the plant. And it's really going to say, hey, it's time to stop growing. It's time to think about fruiting. And within 7 to 10 days, if you see those two dots, those are present, you will get the figs forming on your tree. So this is a really great way to absolutely force your tree into fruiting. And it's a method that I use every single year here without fail, because I live in a shorter season climate. I live here in Pennsylvania, zone 7A, and we only have about 6 months of frost-free days. So to get these fig trees to fruit in 6 months is a bit of a challenge. So that's what I'm doing today, is I'm going around all my trees, seeing which branches I can pinch, which ones I can't, and then making a decision, a judgment call, and taking off the tip. Let me show you guys a couple examples here. So on this particular tree, we have a really thick limb here. If I look really closely, you can see the two dots here, you can see it over here. You can see all up and down this branch. It's a really thick, strong branch. So we can take the tip off here. And what that's going to do is stop the growth on this particular branch. And then these lower branches down here that are less thick, not as vigorous, because that auxin, that hormone in all trees, is suppressing the lower growth. So if we take off this tip up here on this really thick and strong branch, we're then going to remove that auxin. And it's then gonna free up some energy to then be put into this branch here to then grow, become stronger, become healthier, so that if it does indeed do that, about a couple weeks later, when it does get stronger and healthy, I can come back in here and pinch that branch. So I don't have to be pinching every single branch on the tree. I don't have to be pinching every single branch in the same day. I can really make really good judgment calls here. This particular branch is the highest point on the tree, so this is probably most likely going to be my first branch that I pinch on this particular variety. It also has the thickest, strongest growth. It's going to put out probably the most fruit and probably the earliest fruits. So we can take this tip off again, let these other weaker, thinner branches come through, get some growth on them, and about 15 days, 20 days from now, I can come in and pinch the rest of these. That's normally what I do here in my climate. As I come in here sometime around May 1st, May 15th, June 1st, June 15th, and then that the very last date is July 1st. Why is that the last date for me? Because 90 days later, after we pinch these trees, that's when you have a ripe fruit. And 90 days after July 1st, you're getting into really cold temperatures. You're getting into the potential for frost, and that's not what we want. We want to have all these fruits form for us in the hottest part of our year, in the driest part of our year. That is when the fruit quality is going to be at its finest. And if you guys live in California or a really warm climate, kind of opposite to mine, this is also a strategy that you can use every single year. Just because I live in a cold place doesn't mean that you don't have to be doing this for yourself. However, if you have enough heat and you have enough time in your season, these fruits are naturally going to form. In my climate, they're not going to naturally form. I have to have some sort of assistance here by using this technique of taking off the tip to induce those fruits to get these trees to fruit for me. A lot of people in my area, I get the question all the time, how can I get my tree to fruit earlier? This is the answer. It all comes down to pinching, and even more important, before we even get to this point, is the process of thinning out these branches, right? This branch up here is quite thick, whereas this one's down here is not as thick. If this branch had more branches on it, more growth points on it, I mean, this would be a lot less thick, and so would this. So the whole goal here of my season here in this climate is to really get these branches as thick and strong as possible, thin out the new growth, select the branches you want, fertilize these trees really heavily. We've already fertilized them twice. Today we're also going to give them a nice dose of fertilizer, hopefully something high in nitrogen at this point of the season. Once the fruits then form, you give them a nice shot of phosphorus that's going to help with blooming and fruiting, and continue on with the energy into those fruits, and we should be good. It's all really up to the grower here. That's why the fig tree is fruiting or not fruiting, and that's why I love fig trees so much, is not only is the fruit great, but you can control these trees and tell them what to do at your will. You can bend them to your will. You can play God in a way and say, hey, fig tree, fruit. So I want to just pass this little technique on to everybody. If you thought this was helpful, give this one a thumbs up, subscribe. Check out our other videos on pinching. We've done a whole lot of different videos on pinching. Give this one a nice little share. Check us out on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Check out the new blog too, rossratty.wixsite.com/blog. And I hope to catch you guys for more videos. We'll see you for tomorrow's video. Take care, everyone.